Donald Trump, epic fail. He decides to go after Rihanna, saying it was the worst halftime performance he has ever seen. Let's put it up, full mass. All right, this is interesting. Donald J. Trump, on his failed social media site called Truth Social, wrote, epic fail. Rihanna gave, without question, the single worst halftime show in Super Bowl history. This after insulting far more than half of our nation, which is already in serious decline with her foul and insulting language. Also, so much for her stylist. Now, is that not the epitome of white privilege? A man who literally has the worst hairdo of any president in known history is talking about the stylist of the fashionable, pregnant, beautiful black woman, Rihanna. In addition to that, he has the audacity to criticize her because he says she has a foul mouth and she insults people. The man who literally had a campaign methodology of insulting anyone who opposed him in order to become president of the United States. He adopted an insult now, insult later, insult always strategy. And he wants to criticize a black woman for insulting people. There's more. Perhaps unsurprisingly, Donald Trump was not a fan of a certain halftime show on Sunday Night Super Bowl. After Rihanna's, incandescent performance, the former president took to Truth Social to rail about the epic fail of a set. All right? So he gives that ridiculous comment. His latter comment was in seeming reference to an earlier message he posted to Truth Social on Thursday, blasting the singer, the 34-year-old, as talentless, ahead of the game. Okay? There's more. Representative Ronny Jackson, resurrecting a 2020 incident which Rihanna posed in front of an art installation with the words F Trump spray painted across it. Now, let me highlight a couple of nuances here. Remember when Trump was president of the United States? He came after Colin Kaepernick. Colin Kaepernick was engaged in a peaceful protest to bring awareness to what? Unarmed black and brown people being killed by the police that should be alive today. That was what the knee was about. You don't get more peaceful than kneeling before a game during a song by yourself, not disrupting another person. So it's a nonviolent, very peaceful protest. The nation had a problem with this protest. Now remember, before this Colin Kaepernick knee taking, people on the right were saying, we don't mind protests, we just want you to be peaceful. We don't mind protests, we just want it to be nonviolent. You see, first of all, protest is not a protest unless it makes someone uncomfortable. It is required to be a protest. Doesn't need to be violent, but it does need to cause discomfort. Somebody needs to feel something. Number two, when Colin Kaepernick took a knee, it was not the act of taking a knee that offended Donald Trump. It was not the act of taking a knee that offended conservatives and owners in the NFL. Because remember, how many people throw a touchdown or score one and they take a knee for white Jesus? How many times does that happen? Did anybody have a problem with them taking a knee? No, not at all. It was about what he took a knee for. You see, if Colin Kaepernick would have taken a knee to bring awareness to more cancer research money in the United States of America, if he would have taken a knee to bring awareness to the environment, but he had the audacity to take a knee for black and brown people. It was not Colin taking a knee. It was what he took a knee over. Now you have Donald Trump, once again, adversarial to elements in the NFL. Why? Because it is red meat to his base. As I predicted before he announced he would run for president, I said Donald Trump, due to the fact he has lost significant popularity, will run even more so to the bottom in order to gain traction. And that's what he's doing. Rickey, what are your thoughts on this debacle, dear brother?
Talking about the most gaslighting person on the face of the earth. If the word gaslighting was a definition, he would definitely have his picture in the block. Let's talk about, you're talking about Rihanna's epic fail. How about that epic 2020 loss?
That's right.
How about all of the candidates that you endorsed in the midterm election? How about the polling numbers showing that Ron DeSantis is going to whip you in the Republican primary? And how about that epic loss, that phone call to the Secretary of State of Georgia trying to find you 11,000 something votes, as he say. So also losing a lot of your big fundraisers. His whole presidency was an epic loss, and just on how you handled things in Ukraine, which is now playing out, and how you handled things in Russia, you know, when you was president of the United States. So Rihanna having, if you say Rihanna's loss, I have a whole list, a full list of losses during the Trump administration.
Dear brother, I could not have put it better myself. The man has been taking L's for a long time, but once again, he's a winner because, you know, he's a powerful white guy. He's gonna always win.